Good morning, dear friends. Welcome to WE Knowledge Channel. I am Dr. Reginam Linesh, Associate Professor and HOD of Electrical Engineering Department at Sanjay Godavati University, Kolhapur. In the last lecture, under wind energy conversion system, we have learned about what is meant by yaw control and what is meant by pitch control. Based on that, we have understood that wind velocity variation we have divided into different region. In between 0 to V cutting speed, then V cutting to V rated, then V rated to cutout speed. So we came to know that between 0 to cutting speed wind velocity and V rated to cutout wind velocity, we used to go for pitch angle control. We already know whenever that the wind is all the wind, we are making the position of the blade, it is perpendicular to the flow of wind. Directly, it is allowing all the wind to hit in the blade. That is called as pitch angle 0 degree. Whenever the blade is like this, then it is parallel to this flow direction of wind velocity. So we will take that is a pitch angle 90 degree. So with respect to the head, it will be this will be the 0 degree and it will be 90 degree and this will be 0 degree. So before going to this next topic about the simulation of pitch angle control using MATLAB simulink, so those who have not subscribed this channel, kindly subscribe it and press the bell button also so that you can get more videos related to this wind energy conversion system and other technical videos. So let me share my presentation for explaining this MATLAB simulation. Before that, I would like to explain something in this whiteboard as well. Already we know that we are going to split this wind velocity as, let me check. Wind velocity variation as 0, V cutting, then V rated, then V cutout. So in this region where we can use this pitch angle control. Then similarly, this region also we will use this pitch angle control. This is not control, actually we are making this pitch angle here 90 degree and making this wind turbine halt as the power production from the wind turbine is less, or maybe it will draw the power from the grid. So similarly, this region here above cutting speed also we will make pitch angle, we will normally call it as beta, we will make beta is equal to 90 degree. So let me take some of the wind turbine parameters. So wind turbine speed in RPM is 211. Use another way. Speed of wind turbine is nothing but 211 RPM. If we convert into radian per second, it will be 211 divided by 60 by 2 pi. 60 by 2 pi, so we can have 22.09 RPS. Then power of the wind turbine power of the wind turbine P is equal to 20 kilowatts. Assume that V rated wind velocity. You can go through this previous video also for what is mean by V rated and how one can define V rated and all. So V rated, it is nothing but 12 meter per second. So velocity, let me take the small v, velocity is 12 meter per second. Then we cut out wind velocity also, we can take it as 25 meter per second. So I will choose V cut in wind velocity, maybe below 6 meter per second based on the power production. I will let you know. So now I am assuming that wind cut in wind velocity is 6 meter per second. So below, otherwise in the practical cases it will be 3 meter per second. So you can take as it is, V cut in is equal to 3 meter per second. So our region is from 0 to 3 meter per second. We have to make beta, pitch angle is equal to 90 degree. Then from 3 meter per second to 12 meter per second, we are going to make pitch angle is equal to 0. Then 12 meter per second to 25 meter per second, again we are making pitch angle is increasing, greater than or equal, greater than 0. Just we are increasing 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 30, 40 angle. Then above, greater than, then we have to take, if suppose this pitch angle is, this wind velocity is greater than 25 meter per second, again we will make pitch angle is equal to 90 degree. This is what we have learned. So now let me take that MATLAB simulation. So this is the, I hope it is very clear to you for visibility. So now this is, let me explain one by one. In this, we can get it from this wind turbine model, from this MATLAB. I have mentioned here 20 kilowatts, 211 RPM. So now the generator speed, the nominal generator speed, we can take nominal mechanical output power, I am taking it as 20 kilowatts mechanical output power. That base power of the electrical generator, base power of the electrical generator also, maybe in volt ampere you can take. I am assuming that the power factor is 0.9, therefore I am writing it here 0.9. So 2020 kilowatts divided by 0.9. then base wind speed, the base wind speed is nothing but rated wind speed, 12 meter per second. Then maximum power at the base wind speed, I am assuming 1 per unit. This we have to take it as a 1 per unit. That means if I have, now if my wind velocity is 12 meter per second, that time I will get that maximum power of 220 kilowatts. Then base rotor speed also I am taking it as 1 per unit. One means, that means 211 is nothing but 1 per unit. 211 divided by, you already know per unit is equal to actual value divided by base value, therefore 211 divided by 211, therefore 1. Similarly, this power is also 220 kilowatts divided by 20 kilowatts, therefore it is equal to 1. Then pitch angle will be 0. Now if you see this, see here, at 1 per unit as base wind speed, this is 12 meter per second, you are getting the maximum power of 1 per unit. So from this you can come to know the speed input to the turbine also per unit, output which we are getting it also in per unit, so that we can generalize to model based on the power requirement we can utilize. Then I hope it is understand. So now see, 6 meter per second, this optimum power we will get this point. Then if you reduce further, maybe 3 meter per second and all, we will get very less value. But you have to consider what is the optimum points, how you have to get the optimum points. I will tell you in the next lecture for tip speed ratio control. Now I am not concentrating this tip speed ratio control. That means I am not at all I am not at all going to explain this control, this region. Control this region. This is a separate control I have to do. That is called as tip speed ratio control. Tip speed ratio control. So this video, this lecture will not show explain about this tip speed ratio control. Then let me take this MATLAB simulink. So what happened? I already told you generator speed is equal to per unit. That is it. So already we know generator speed is coupled with wind turbine. Therefore, generator speed is same as turbine speed. Now I am assuming that gear ratio is 1. So that means we are not at all connecting any gear. It is equal to 1. So now we will have the speed of 90. So this output is will be the torque. The torque normally we will get negative value. So most of the model in the MATLAB, the generator mode will be negative torque. That is why the torque output will be negative value in per unit. So now I have done the remaining things. So now I am going to vary this wind velocity from 0 to 12 or 12 to 25 and all. So that I am taking this power wind velocity as the block, constant block. Pitch angle I already fixed it as 0. Maybe you can take it as beta, that is equal to 0. Then generator speed. The generator speed we know already. The generator speed is 211 RPM. So first I have convert this two. First I have convert 211 RPM to RPS by multiplying the same what I have explained in this board. How 60 divided by 2 pi. I have just dividing it. So dividing it means 2 pi divided by 60. I have done here. Then RPS to per unit. RPS to per unit already we know. We know that whenever we are doing converting this RPM to RPS, this is will be 22 RPS. So that output RPM to per unit, I am dividing by 22. So that actual value divided by base value 22, I am giving this to generator speed. So the display also, it is connected to understand what is the value of the generator speed in the display. Then torque, the torque calculation also another one important factor. Let me take another one page of for torque calculation. In this torque calculation, already we know power is equal to radian per second into this torque. So already we know this omega is nothing but 22 RPS. Then power is nothing but 20 kilowatts. So from this we can calculate torque is nothing but 20 kilowatts divided by 22. That is equal to we will have approximately 905 newton meter. So this is your actual value. The rated torque is 905. A rated torque at rated speed and rated power. So we will have 905. So that I am just multiplying this two. This is a per unit value into base value is 905 is nothing but your torque. The torque we can get it as in actual in a meter, in newton meter. So that's I have connected. Then this torque output and this power output, you are combinedly connecting to this output power by using this product, so that this is equal to output power. I hope this is very much clear for understanding. So speed to RPM conversion, then speed RPM to RPS conversion, then RPS to per unit conversion, then pitch angle, the wind velocity we have given, conversion of per unit to actual value, then generator speed display. So now assume I am using this 211. Already told you cutting speed, cutout speed is 12 meter per second. So whenever the power production is positive, so whenever power production is there, torque output will be negative. Automatically power will be also negative. Whenever torque output is positive, that in the sense it will act as a motor, so it will draw from the power from the grid. So assume that now our cutting wind, let me go through this previous slide. I have already told you that this is the region where I am going to do now. This is another one region where 12 meter per second to 25 meter per second. This is another one region. This is what I am interested today to explain. So now in this case, now I am taking, this is the rated wind velocity, rated speed 211, wind velocity 12 meter per second. Please check now the simulation. We will have I think some of the windows are open. Let me check. Pitch angle is 0 and the maximum wind speed is 0.9. Now if you see here, approximately you are having the power of 17 kilowatts. So if suppose if you make this is also to 20e power 3, based on the machine design you can use. Now I am assuming that the power factor is one. If that is the case, you will get approximately 20 kilowatts per. Then see, speed is 211, wind velocity is rated speed. At that time we are getting 20 kilowatts. Now if you see here, now for two, instead of wind velocity 12 meter per second, if I make it this 13 meter per second, what happen? Power production from the wind turbine is more than the rated power, 24 kilowatts, but our production will be only 20 kilowatts. So for that, what happen? We have to use pitch angle control. I will increase this pitch angle instead of 0 to 1 degree. So automatically what will happen? This pitch power production will be reduced. Then if I increase it again to, we will get approximately 20 kilowatts. So that we are in this position, whenever wind velocity is 13 meter per second, so we the speed is rated speed, we cannot increase the motor speed beyond that, generator speed beyond that. So that we are increasing pitch angle and maintaining the rated power is constant. Then again, if we increase this wind velocity 14 meter per second, the 14 meter per second, again this output power will be 22 kilowatt. So accordingly, I have to reduce this to, maybe I will increase this pitch angle to 4, so that we will get again to then 21 kilowatts. Again, I am ready increasing to 5 kilowatts, so that approximately you are getting 20 kilowatts, angle is 5, so that this way you can vary till 24 meter per second. In this 24 meter per second, see, if this is the angle, power production is 38 kilowatts. So power generator will not generate that much. It is not having a capacity to generate. So that what happen, I am increasing this pitch angle to assume around 40 degree, so that we will have, again I am increasing to 60. Let me check how the, see, now it is reducing to 24 kilowatt. If you make it around 85 degree, automatically maybe you will get this power of you cannot vary this till only 40% only you can vary in practical cases. So let me run it for 50, so that you can realize this power is again reducing. So better you can make it now 40, you will have the power angle again 38 kilowatts. So that one beyond particular limit, this pitch angle will not help you. So that what happen, I will make this pitch angle 90 degree, so that automatically power production will be very less. So this is all the positive value, previously negative value, right? Negative value, positive value means very less value. So that we have to make this generator to run, then speed also we have to make it halt, so that output power will be automatically zero. So that whenever the pitch angle reaches 90 degree, we will make generator speed is zero, turbine speed is zero, as well as pitch angle should be 90 degree, so that output power will be zero. Then let me explain about this, whenever the wind velocity is below cutting speed. So that, for example, if we have the wind velocity of 2 meter per second, this is, in this case, if we have this wind velocity of 2 meter per second, in this 2 meter per second, we are making this pitch angle already zero. Then if you make this current as the speed as approximately around maybe 100, assume that 100 RPM. So if you run it, you are getting positive value of output power. What is meant by positive value of output power? And the positive of value of output power in the sense, it will draw the power from the grid. Therefore, we cannot, it will not produce any power. So that what we are going to do, whenever the wind velocity is below 6 meter per second, till 6 meter per second, based on the output speed, we are getting power. We are getting power now 2 kilowatts, 2.4 kilowatts we are getting. So whenever the pitch angle, the wind velocity is below cutting speed, it will act as a motor. So it will draw the power from the grid, so that it will not help the power system. But in this normal cases, practical cases, what we will do, we will disconnect the wind turbine from this grid, and just for overcome the inertia effect, till the wind cutting wind speed, we will run this simulation. We will allow the turbine to run, so that from 3 meter per second to we can use this. We can extract the power from the wind turbine. So I hope this simulation will help you. So moreover, in this, when I explain this cutting, the operation of 0 to V cut-in, it is necessary I have to explain tip speed ratio control, then only you can easily understand this region. I hope the importance of pitch angle control above, you understood the rated wind velocity. With this, I would like to conclude this today's lecture. Those who have not subscribed this channel, kindly subscribe it and press the bell button also, so that the coming lectures you can easily and you can trace out and you can learn. One more thing, I am going to mention this all the playlist in this description of this video. Wish you all the best. Thank you.